Jevamai shekita sauhidartha janesho dehantaravartikeshu geheshu jayatma jarati matsu na priti yukta yavadarthascha loke Jevamai shekita sauhidartha janesho dehantaravartikeshu geheshu jayatma jarati matsu na priti yukta yavadarthascha loke Gauriya Goshtipati Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupad told that until and unless we are going to show our 100% submission unto the lotus feet of Guru Padma, we cannot start our bhajan. Bhajan, we cannot start Hari Bhajan. We cannot start Hari Bhajan until and unless we are 100% inclined unto the lotus feet of Supreme Lord. Hari Bhajan not started. Srila Sachidananda Bhaktivinoda Thakur told that any spiritual organization established or set by some material people, some rajastama tarito, those who are having rajatama gun, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, a spiritual organization set by some, established by some material person having rajatama gun, they are staying there. So by them, we cannot expect idealism can be preached. Adarsho, any ideal teachings cannot be preached by them. Not only that, but also by their dirty activities, outside people can express their bitterness, hatred, and spit on them. That is a dangerous situation. So any spiritual organization established by material persons and those who are rajastama tarito people, they are staying there, we cannot expect ideal teachings can be preached by them. It is not possible. Actually, point is that jeva mai shekito sauhidartha, you can remember The other day I was speaking that until and unless you are feeling strong attraction for Aprakita Kamdev, be sure very shortly Mayadevi is going to throw you into the ocean of misery. Prakita Kamdev can overpower you. I was speaking about this point. Jeva mai shekito sauhidartha, same thing. Those who are not developing tremendous attraction, love for Guru, Vaishnava and Bhagavan, we cannot expect they can start actual Hari Bhajan. It's not possible. That day I was speaking about Chatusloki Bhagavatam, and the last talk I was speaking that Brahmaji, in front of Brahmaji, Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking, Javanaham Jatabhava Yadrupa Gunamukarma Kahatativa Tatta Vijnanam Ustitya Madanugrahat Ahom Ivasa Mivagrinanaja Sasat Param Paschadaham Jadeta Chijavasisuasmiham Rithiartan Jatpatitana Pratiti Chatmanitat Bidvat Manamayam Jatabhasu Jatatamaha Jatha mahanti bhutani bhuteshu uchyavashi shonu pravishthanu pravishthani tatha teshu na teshu ham. Etava deva jigyasam tatva jigyasunatanaha anna evayati reka abhyam jatsat sarvadu sarvada. Etat matam samatishta paramena sabandhina bhavanu kalpa vikalpeshu na bhimajitikarichit. That's it. Bhavano kalpo vikalpesu no vimhijitu kahirchit. Etat matam samatishto. I already giving you advice, Bhagavat Tattva Vigyan. I already giving you Bhagavat Tattva Vigyan and some advice, you see. Etat matam samatishto. If you can accept all my advice and Tattva Vigyan, etat matam samatishto. Samatishto manas sammak rupena tishtati. If you are going to stay very peacefully, because you have no pain of any enjoyment, you have no enjoying moods. So in that case, etat matam samadhishta parameno samadhina. Parameno samadhina means, samadhi means, you can see only one thing. Dhyan, dheyo, dhyan, you know, meditation. Dheyo means the object I am going to meditate. Dhyan, dheyo. Follow. An uninterrupted dhyan, meditation is called samadhi. No outside thing. No outside thing there, nothing. Only dheyo object. Your ishtavastu is there. I mean, lila, parikar, vaishishto, all adhyay gyan tattva, total, one tattva there. In that case, what happens, you know? Then your paramen, itat matam samadhishto parameno samadhina, itat matam samadhishto parameno samadhina, parameno itat matam, what I advise you, samadhishto, sammagrupena tishtati. Tishta means you have to stay very, very peacefully, automatically. Etat matam samadhishta parameno samadhina. Now not samadhi, parameno samadhina. Bhavan, mani you. Bhavan is actually honorable. Tatra bhavan, atra bhavan. Bhavan we see very honorable word. So bhavan kalpa vikalpeshu. This kalpa or next kalpa, any bhavan kalpa vikalpeshu. Na vimujyati kaharichit. It is my blessing, it is my blessing that you are not going to feel any disturbance. Because your seva is very dangerous seva. Creation. Rajas seva to. By the order of Supreme Lord, Brahma doing. Now what I want to say, that without the blessings of Guru, Vaishnava and Bhagavan, perfect, we cannot start actual Hari Bhajan, not possible. Jovanam dhana sampatti prabhutyam avivekita. Jovanam, young age, blood is very hot. Jovanam dhana sampatti prabhutyam avivekita. Prabhutyam means mastership. I like to get control over you, everybody. Everybody can worship me. This call actually very dangerous. Many times Prabhupada used to speak, when I am going to get control over whole society, when this is my mood to get control over this material society, be sure that is a dangerous bondage for me, topmost bondage. Because it is also Yoshit Sangha, na? I already explained what do you mean by Yoshit. Different kind of Yoshit, Pratishtha Yoshit, Kamini Yoshit, Kanchan Yoshit, Pratishtha Yoshit, it is also Yoshit. Na tathasya bhavet bandho. Na tathasya bhavet bandho. Bandhascha anna prasangata yoshit sangyad yatha pungso tatha tatsangi sangata. You should remember this slok. Na tathasya bhavet bandho. That much, you know, tight position you cannot be in. You can never be in such a tight position. You cannot be in such a tight position if you are not going to do Yasi Sangha. And if you are going to do Yasi Sangha, na tatha asya bhavet bandhu, that kind of bondage you cannot expect. What kind of bondage? That big bondage. This is the strongest bondage. When you are going to do Yasi Sangha, Yasi Sangha yatha pungso, tatha tatsangi sangata. Those who are running for Yasi Sangha, and those who are getting the association of those people, those who are going for us, Yasi Sangha, follow. Those who are directly doing Yasi Sangha, and those who are going to get the association of those people, those who are going to do Yasi Sangha, their Sangha is also dangerous. So, na tathasya bhavet bandho bandhascha anna pasangata, Yasi Sangad yatha pungsa tatha satsangi sangataha. So, jovanam and young age, yod, dhanasampatti means your riches, dhanasampatti, prabhuttam, your lordship, you want to get control over whole world situation. And prabhuttam avivekita, avivekita means injustice. No rationality is there, you cannot understand. You cannot think, you know, what to do, what not to do. You cannot take decision. You cannot take decision. Prabhuttam avivekita, avivekita means there is no, you know, judgment inside you. Avivek, loss of consciousness, loss of memory. All can put you in the ocean of misery. So before doing Hari Bhajan, we must be very careful. Jovanam yote is very dangerous. In that case, if I am not going to follow any Guru Vaishnava, in that case I cannot control myself. It's not possible. Dhanasampaddi reaches also, that Kunti Devi also speaks same thing, na? Kunti Devi also speaking same thing. Janmaisajya suto sivi redhamana madahapamana naiva arati avidatumbai tamakinchana gocharam. Only and only those who are akinchan, they can do actual Hari Bhajan. Only and only those who are akinchan, niskinchan. Niskinchan mean? Only property Krishna. Only property. The only property. Krishna is there in his life. That is called akinchan. And all other things, relative things, okay, no problem. If I can relate everything, if I can relate everything and everybody in respect to Krishna Bhajan, then there is no problem. That is the secret technique of Bhajan. Why our Guru Varga is so elevated? Why we follow our Guru Varga? Because they are having this kind of technique. How to relate everything and everybody in relation to Krishna Bhajan. Even one wicked person, very dangerous person there, we have seen, Paramija Madhava Goswami Maharaj, and all big Acharya, they were successful to utilize them in Krishna Seva. Though they don't know that they are doing Krishna Seva, but still they have the technique how to engage him in Seva. How to engage them in Seva, that technique is there with them. So, Yukta Vairagya and all these things you must understand first. And today is the disappearance day of Srila Bhakti Kumud Santo Goswami Maharaj. If we discuss all about our Guru Varga, their Seva, non-stop Seva. Non-stop Seva mood. That day I was speaking, na? Until and unless I am going to develop non-stop Seva mood unto the lotus feet of one Tattva Jnani Purush, I cannot go out of material bondage. Until and unless I am going to develop non-stop seva mood unto the lotus feet of Tattva Jnani Purush, till then there is no way out. Big problem. Srila Santo Goswami Maharaj is disappearance day today. He was successful to teach us, some of us, not everybody. He was successful in his bhajan, I mean Nitya Parshad he is. But still, he was successful Acharya. What I mean to say? He was successful Acharya. What do you mean by successful Acharya? Successful Acharya means who can inculcate his teachings and adarsha inside us. He is successful Acharya. He is successful Acharya who can inculcate his seva mood. What Gurudev can do? What Siddha Mahatma, Gurupad Padma, what Gurupad Padma can do? Gurupad Padma can try his best to inculcate his seva mood inside me. That is his success. Achi noti jo swastvartham achare sapayati opi. Swayam acharate yasmat acharyo steno kirtita. He is successful acharya who can give you inspiration. Who can give you inspiration in Krishna bhajan? Who can give you inspiration in Krishna bhajan? You become very interested to follow your Gurudev. You become very much interested to follow your Gurudev. That's mean, if you are inclined unto the lotus feet of Guru Padma can inculcate his seva mood. Continuous seva mood inside your heart. That is your success. In that case, you can say you are disciple. In that case, you can deserve that you are disciple because you are going to serve Guru Vaishnava continuously, non stop. His name was Radharaman Prabhu. Radharaman Prabhu, Srila Santo Goswami Maharaj. His name was Radharaman Prabhu and Midnapur, there, one place. He was from Jamindar family, very nice family, big family. When Bhakti Hidra Bhunadev Goswami Maharaj and Srila Bhakti Pamapuri Goswami Maharaj went there for preaching, in that case, by hearing Harikatha, that small boy was very much interested. In Hari Bhajan, actually, his uncle, father, all family, they are also already they are, you know, taking shelter onto the lotus feet of Prabhupada. They are the disciples of his uncle was there in Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, used to sing Kirtan very nicely. I forget the name. Continuous Kirtan, very nice. So in their house, Radharaman Vigraha, there, in their house, deity, home deity, there. So when Maharaj was very, very small boy, in that case, there, Srila Banugasi Maharaj and Srila Bhakti Pumat Purgishi Maharaj, I mean, that time, not Bhakti Pumat Purgishi, that time actually, Paramananda Prabhu, Panamananda Prabhu, he went there, and by Harikatha and Kirtan, he was very much attracted. He wanted to come. And Gurupad Padma and Sira Bhakti Yudha Manadu Goswami asking to his father, you like to give your son for Hari Bhajan? He's speaking, okay, well, if he like to go, he can go, no problem. Then with them, he came here in Dham. took shelter unto the lotus feet of Prabhupada. First he took Harinam and within very short time, because they are Nitya Siddha Parshad, Prabhupada can watch everything what is there inside their heart. So he took Harinam Diksha, everything, and doing bhajan there with a small boy. Very energetic, full of energy, enthusiastic energy. Like, you know, about Srila Bhakti with Madhav Goswami Maharaj, Prabhupada used to say, volcanic energy. So about Srila Santo Goswami Maharaj, the small boy, Radharaman Prabhu, it was very big energy all the time. So Prabhupada used to love him very much and give him some seva sometime. Time to time he used to say. Usually he used to go with some devotees, those who are going for preaching. Those who are going for preaching in different places, Maharaj used to send him in different place for preaching. In Thailand also, Shyam desh. There also, he went for preaching there. Continuous seva. And naturally, from childhood, he is hearing all Vaishnava Tattva and Siddhanta. He is growing profound knowledge automatically. So when started hearing Harikatha from Prabhupada directly, he was like fire. So Maharaj speaking directly to me one day, that one day Prabhupada giving instruction to me that you will have to speak Harikatha. I was very frightened, very small boy, how I can speak Harikatha? So it was the usual system that every member, most of the member, those staying in Gauriya Mission, Gauriya Mott, they will have to speak Harikatha. That was the system. Prabhupada used to give instruction, you will have to speak Harikatha today. You will have to speak Harikatha today. This was the usual system. Bhakti Pumat Puri Krishna Maharaj also used to speak daily Harikatha almost. They are in Gauriya Mission. This way, so Srila Santo Goswami Maharaj speaking that day, Prabhupada giving order that you will have to speak Harikatha. I don't know what to speak, I am a small boy. So, in the afternoon time, I was sitting in Vyasasana and praying unto the lotus feet of Prabhupada so that I can speak something. In that case, I was feeling some power. After Bandana, I started Harikatha. And after Harikatha is over, somebody speaking, Prabhupada hearing Harikatha from balcony. Santomas is, I couldn't realize that Prabhupada hearing Harikatha from balcony. Very dangerous. So, Prabhupada speaking, as is very young age, is very speaking very nicely. Very nicely. So, always having seva mood, very nice seva mood. Any seva, Prabhupada speaking, you can do this seva? Yes, I can do. This way, always expressing. So, one day, actually, in Gauriya Patrika, Prabhupada giving instruction to Radharaman Brahmachari to write some article about Guru Tattva. And Srila Santo Goswami Maharaj was a small boy. He started writing about Guru Tattva, all Guru Tattva. After writing, is sending into Gauriya Mission. After editing, it was the system after editing. Everybody writing, after that Prabhupada can check up. Gauriya editor is there also. Finally, Prabhupada can check up if there is any mistake. After that, it was the usual system. They can publish it. Then there, the Gauriya editor was very surprised to see one word there, that Jive Swarup Hoy Guru Nitya Das. He was very surprised. He speaking to Prabhupada, Prabhupada, Radharaman Brahmachari, how dare he is speaking this way? He is speaking, actually changing the word of Chaitanya Charitamrita, quotation. From Chaitanya Guru, Jive Sarupai Krishna Nitya Das. But he is writing Jive Sarupai Guru Nitya Das. So, what to do? Pope was speaking, actually, Radharaman is a very small boy, but actually his writing is okay, nice, no problem. He is writing perfect thing. You will have to publish it. So this way it was published. So actually, after Pope had gone, when Prabhupada is there continuously, he is doing seva all the time. At present, we think that if we can hear sweet, sweet philosophy, then that is called Harikatha. But whole life we have seen Srila Santo Goswami speaking very heavily. Srila Santo Goswami Maharaj always speaking heavy Siddhanta all the time. All the time speaking heavy Siddhanta, never compromise with any Sahajiya, nothing. So heavy, all the time speaking. From Chaitanya Charitamrita, one sloka we can find that Kaya Mano Bakhe Kare Udbeg Nadive. Kaya Mano Bakhe Kare Udbeg Nadive. In Chaitanya Charitamrita, we find one sloka there. What is the meaning? Kaya means body speech, by body speech and mind, you should not give any pain to anybody. Kaya mano bakhe kare udbegna tension. You should not give any tension to anybody by your body, speech and mind. But most of the people, those who are preaching, they are going to misuse this point. They are going to misuse this point. Kaya mano bakhe kare udbegna dibe. With body speech or by body speech of mind, we should not give tension to anybody. We cannot take undue advantage of this slog, and we cannot stop speaking all about that absolute truth. We cannot take undue advantage of this sloka. That is written. Kaya mano bakhe kare udbeg na dibe. You should not give tension to anybody by body speech of mind. We should not give any tension to anybody. We should not take undue advantage of this sloka, and we cannot stop speaking all about that absolute truth, absolute way. This is not good. That's why Prabhupada also, in his last, when Prabhupada going away, Antim Bani, it is called Antim Bani, meaning last advice. When Prabhupada going away from this middle in bed, then before that, Prabhupada giving some advice. That was published by Parampriya Bhakti with Madhav Goswami Maharaj also, Bhakti Mayuk Bhagavad Goswami Maharaj also. From the time to time it was published. The first advice, first, that time, so many advice, last advice. That time Prabhupada speaking, for actual Harivajan, to engage you all in actual Harivajan, I was bound to put you in trouble. I was bound to put pressure on you. I was bound to give tension to you to engage you all in actual Harivajan. That is why so many people misunderstood me. That is why most of them misunderstood me. Someday, if their luck is very good, someday they can understand me properly. If they are going to grow their consciousness day by day, someday they can understand the how much love and affection I have for them. Why I was bound to put them in trouble, or why I was bound to speak them about absolute truth, absolute way. Why I was bound to give them tension only to engage them in actual Harivajan? Only to engage them in actual Harivajan. Actually, Prabhupada speaking, Prabhupada always used to speak this way. If you want to speak about that absolute truth, And if you are interested to speak about the absolute truth, but if you have some, you know, if you have some wrong mood, negative mood to get some popularity. Popularity, and at the popularity, you want to enjoy popularity. At the same time, you want to preach. These two cannot be there. Either you can enjoy popularity or you can speak all about the absolute truth. If you are going to speak about the absolute truth, surely you are not going to enjoy. You are going to enjoy popularity. Both at a time you cannot do. So, Prabhupada speaking, until and unless you are 100% inclined at the lotus feet of Sadguru and Bhagavan, you have no right to speak about the absolute truth. You cannot get inspiration. You cannot get power. You cannot get power to speak about that absolute truth. You cannot speak. You will have to dodge. Dodge, you know, pass away. So, actually, at present, those who actually at present, the technique of preaching is there. You will have to suppress the absolute truth. The more you are successful to suppress that absolute truth, the more you can get popularity. Then you are big preacher. Big preacher means those who can suppress the absolute truth, they are big preacher. But Paramahansa Keshav Goswami used to speak, Prabhupada also used to speak, half truth is not truth. If you are going to speak half truth, then you would be punished. Half truth is not actually truth. So we cannot expect. So our Guru Bhargo, actually, those who are preaching extensive, big way, havoc, they are going here and there by the order of Srila Prabhupada. So it was their duty to speak about their absolute truth, because it was standing instruction of Srila Prabhupada. He will have to speak the mercy of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Don't try to go into compromise with anybody. So we like to get undue advantage of this world. And we want to prove that we are great Vaishnava, very soft. We want to prove this way. But Santo Goswami Maharaj, Paramahansa Keshav Goswami Maharaj, we never find. They are always speaking heavily, because they have tremendous love for us. So all the time, Srila Santo Goswami, I heard from senior devotees that Srila Santo Goswami Maharaj used to beat with wooden sandal, you know, to devotees. Heavily. So heavy, danda and wooden, and karam, Mr. Beat, go away from me. So, at present is very critical situation, very critical. There is a rare scope to hear and speak about their absolute truth. So anyway, after Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada gone, there was some disturbance. But still, we should not take undue advantage of this, thing. Very careful. Paramahansa Keshav Goswami Maharaj in jail, sent in jail, Vinod Vihari. So much dangerous situation. Bhakti Yita Madhav Goswami Maharaj, helpless, no place. Helpless means? We are speaking, actually, he is never helpless. Actually, there is no place to stay this way. And Radharamam Namachari was small. What to do? Where to go? He went to home. Because to save himself, his bhajan. Because he is very not. After that, again he was in he was interested to come back. Then Paramahansa Bhakti to Madhava Goswami Maharaj, Paramahansa Santo Goswami Maharaj, and Srila Jadava Goswami Maharaj, they all make one nice team. They wanted to open one mot. The first mot. They wanted to open one mot there in Rup that was in Midnapur city. Midnapur city, one Jamindar house. It was back in because it's a ghost house. A house is ghost. They wanted to purchase it or take donation. The Jamindar was very, very much interested. Okay, you can take away because it's a ghost house, ghost. After taking, they cleaned that whole building, and started doing kirtan, Harikitan or Harikatha. Even when they started Harikatha kirtan, that time was a big stone, you see, brick, falling down in Basasan, brick, ghost, throwing form, big stone, throw, and break Basasan, this way. So that was the situation. But they are Guru Varga, they are powerful. Paramahansa Madhava Goswami Maharaj, Bhakti Guru Santo Goswami Maharaj, Jadava Goswami Maharaj, they started doing Sankirtan and Harikatha. This way they started preaching. Very nice preaching was done. And they started nice Samananda Gauriyamat. Because Midnapur belt, actually, specially Samananda Prabhu was there. In that preaching field, Samananda Prabhu was there. Rardesh means Bankura or this place actually, Birbhum, that place, the responsibility was there with Srinivasacharya. And this eastern zone, actually Manipur, Tripura, Bengal, at present Bangladesh also you can speak, East Bengal, West Bengal, both one Bengal. Undivided Bengal, their responsibility was there with Narottam Thakur. So all they started speaking about Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's kripa. They started preaching. So they started Samananda Gauriyamat very nicely, joint venture. In the meantime, you know, Srila Bhaktivedanta Madhava Goswami is very powerful, high guru brahmachari. In the meantime, he already started, Chaitanya Gauriyamat, Paramahansa Bhakti, Kumud Santo Goswami also, he wanted to open one mat, another in Keshiari also. That time, there was no place where to start mat. Somebody was very interested to give some piece of land, but he requesting Maharaj that you will have to speak one lie. If you can speak one lie, in that case I can give this big piece of land to you for making a temple. You have to speak simple thing. You have to speak the in front of court. Srila Santo Goswami is speaking, I don't like to take your land. I don't like to take your land. I cannot take your land because I cannot speak lie. If it is the desire of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, then I can open mat. I am not going to take. Then in the meantime, he got the scope to get one nice piece of land in Keshiari. Keshiari mat. Keshiari mat was the, first mat started by Sri Santo Goswami. Very my, as Sri Santo Goswami Maharaj started Keshiari mat. Extensive preaching. Like our Swami Maharaj, preaching in all common mass. That kind of preaching is very rare. To attract common mass, that technique was there with Swami Maharaj. All, their drugs and, they are taking Swami Maharaj. That was the special technique adopted. We must confess. So Santo Goswami Maharaj also, his kirtan is so nice, without Harikatha, If he is going to do kirtan, then thousands of people can gather. So attractive kirtan. Only through kirtan, no need of speaking Harikatha. Only through kirtan, kirtan was so attractive. That through kirtan, he was successful to attract thousands of people. Very soon, in the especially in Midnapur belt, he was so successful in his preaching. Oh, many people started coming to him, his truthfulness, his power. And he started giving initiation. Started giving initiation. One by one, people started coming. And after that, he opened another mart in Kharagpur. Kharagpur main city. From station, not so long distance. It is near one hospital, Sadhar Hospital is there. Near that hospital, Kharagpur Hospital, government hospital there. I've been there 2 years back. But I don't find any suitable situation where I can feel comfortable to speak Harikatha. So I stop, don't call me. So anyway, there he started speaking Harikatha this way. Not only that, it was a standing instruction of Srila Bhakti Vilas Tirthakushi Maharaj, Kunjada. It was a standing instruction of Kunjada on him. What? You will have to come to me as and when I am calling to you. As and when. Any time. If I call you, you will have to come to me. Yes. Second order, you will have to organize my parikram. You know? Navadvip Dham parikram? You will have to organize. Okay. Third instruction, you will have to give your first disciple, you will have to give for Chaitanya Seva, Chaitanya Math Seva. You will have to give your first disciple to Chaitanya Math so that he can serve whole life. That Seva, his name is Kanupriya Baba. He loved me from heart. Sam Baba is dancing. So love me. 5, 7, 8 years, when Srila Maharaj leave body, especially that year, I speak Harikatha in main mart there in Behala. Also, they organize another in another Harikatha there in near Bangladesh border. It's called Chatpara. They also arrange, when they speak Srila Kanupriya Baba Maharaj going, see, he expect you must go. I said, sure. If he is going, I must go. He is sitting here, I am sitting here with laughful, you know, gossiping and going there. And in there also they arrange bed here and here. My bed here. So I am speaking Harikatha there, actually. So he is the first disciple of Srila Santa Goswami Maharaj. His age is now around 97, 98, I think so. Or more than that. Maybe 99, I forget. But for a long time I cannot go. And he was, you know, from the very beginning, from the very beginning, Srila Santa Goswami Maharaj, and his age depends 1 year. Santa Goswami Maharaj 1 year senior to him. He used to serve. Now still today he is serving there in Chaitanya Math. He is staying, Bhakti Vijay Bhavan there. So these were three instructions. Not only that, Bhakti Vita Madhav, with Srila Bhakti Vita Madhav Goswami Maharaj, he used to stay most of the time in his preaching, Bhakti Bhaktivinoda and Santa Goswami Maharaj, all the time, in different place, for different place preaching. In Navadvip Dham Parikram, that time is a special, you know, case. Srila Santa Goswami Maharaj and all senior devotees, they used to do kirtan and lead Parikram party. They used to lead Parikram party very nice in different place. So parikram, if you are going to do dham parikram, you will have to do this dham parikram under the guidance of pure Vaishnava. If you are going to do dham parikram yourself, or if you are going to follow some bonded soul or half bonded soul or 90% bonded, 90% 10% bonded condition is still there, In that case, your parikrama is not perfect. Parikrama, actually, you will have to do under the guidance of pure Guru Vaishnava, those who can show Dham Tattva to you. Like Nityananda Babu guiding Jiva Goswami path. Nityananda Babu guiding Jiva Guru Tattva. So this way, Srila Santo Goswami used to guide them, parikram, a very nice parikram, and used to go here and there, speak Harikatha and Kirtan, very nice, lead the whole party. Also, sometime Srila Bhakti Vidya Mahadev Goswami used to call him, especially Ratha Yatra Utsavadi, Bhakti Bhavaturi Goswami, Srila Santo Goswami Mahadev used to join and do Kirtan. Very nice, the Gundicha Manjan, Ratha Yatra. If I can show you the picture, you can go mad. You cannot believe that how it's possible. How is it was possible that time? So all day walking and going for Gundicha Mandir Parikrama, Gundicha Mandir Manjan, Nishinga Mandir Parikram, Nishinga Mandir Kirtans, all they are doing that time. Very nice. Not only that, hours, for hours, they are doing special attraction. They are cleaning temple. But in between, gapping, they start Kirtan. In between, they are doing Kirtan, very nice Kirtan. So all people, they are feeling some ecstatic feeling. And in front of Ratha Yatra special, the king of Jagannath Puri, he gives special facility to Gauriya Vaishnava. Special facility to Gauriya Vaishnava. So, king used to give advantage to them. They are doing in front of Ratha Yatra, they are doing Kirtan. Even today, the king of Orisha, Jagannath Puri, he is having full respect for Bharati Maharaj. He used to respect Bharati Maharaj also. Sometimes Bharati Maharaj used to go there to invite Gajapati. Follow? Bharati Maharaj sometimes used to go to invite Gajapati in his house. With full respect, he used to love Bharati Maharaj very much. Because from young age he is watching, na, there. So this way actually he used to do Kirtan. So nicely, not only that, in front of Ratha Yatra Kirtan, whole Ratha Yatra. They are never feeling tired. Those devotees, those doing Kirtan with Maharaj, Bhakti Puri Goswami Maharaj, all, no, never feel tired. Krishnadas Babaji Maharaj sometime participate. Very nice Kirtan, sometime. So, you see, so Behala Mat also started there. Manton, there also he started one month, here and there. He was very neutral personality. Srila Santo Goswami Maharaj has some speciality with Maharaj. He is some neutral personality. He never, if you are going to give you some 10,000 donation, 50,000, he can speak about you, not that. Follow? Not that you are going to give 50,000 donation, so he can speak about you, not that. He is very neutral personality. So Maharaj was so neutral personality, I am bound to speak that what is the actual duty of Sabhapati? You know? What is the actual duty of a Sabhapati, chairman of any Sabha? I mean Hari Sabha, not outside Sabha. What is the actual duty of one Sabhapati, chairman of one Vaishnava Sabha? You know? It is the main duty of one Vaishnava Sabhapati in Vaishnava Sabha is to arrange maximum benefit for the audience. Follow? Don't understand. It is the main duty of the chairman of Vaishnava Sabhapati upon Sabha, Vaishnava Sabha. What is the duty? It is his duty to arrange maximum benefit for the common people, those who are hearing Harikatha. Not that he is my, you know, nephew. He is, you know, my relation, he is my friend, I can allow him to speak 30 minutes. I cannot allow Harikatha to him. Not that. No partiality. Maharaj, when sitting in Vyasasan, I have seen also, 1996, Guru Maharaj Vyasa Puja here. Guru Maharaj was manifesting Sikh Leela upstairs. That time I was there, young age, and sitting there, Maharaj going to speak Harikatha. First of all, Maharaj and all devotees going up to pay dandavat to Guru Maharaj. Guru Maharaj crying and speaking, "You all Vaishnav coming, I was supposed to take your go. I was supposed to go down to take your all your kripa, but I am now sick. I cannot go. I am very in a bad luck." Maharaj speaking, Bhakti Bhattacharya speaking, "I was supposed to go down to take all your kripa today, but I am sick." Appearance day of Bhakti Bhattacharya Maharaj. They all pay Puspanjali, and after that we started Harikatha. There Santu Goswami Maharaj speaking, so many devotees came. We have seen the style of running Sabha. At present we don't find. He is sitting in Vyasasan, in actually Vyasasan, as a Sabhapati, and some Maharaj speaking, each and every, you know, Maharaj there. They are Maharaj going to allow them only 15 minutes time for each of them. Some Maharaj speaking, his Acharon is very nice, he is speaking nice Harikatha. He is, 15 minutes is over, he is looking at Maharaj. Maharaj doesn't go on speaking, because his Acharon is very good, he is speaking nice Harikatha, nice way, representation is very nice, Maharaj speaking, go on speaking. At present, we allow only 10 minutes, 5 minutes, like the case, you know, I already told in Baharampur, Prabhupad went there. When Prabhupad, they allow only various, you know, only 10 minutes time. Even 10 minutes time they cannot allow. Stop. They don't allow Prabhupad to speak. This way actually, at present we cannot expect, you know, this kind of situation. What was there that time? So Maharaj used to organize this way, and I am very surprised to see one letter. Maharaj wrote one letter to me, last stage, before manifesting total Sikh Leela and coma state. Before that, I was in Surya Kundo. I was writing one painful letter to Maharaj. So I cannot do Guru Seva. What to do? I don't know. This is the situation. I cannot get the scope to do Guru Seva perfectly. I am bound to stay here to avoid conflict, problem. So Maharaj writing, reading that letter and writing me answer, giving me answer, one big letter. That letter is still there with me. It was printed also. It was also printed in books when Maharaj gone, Bengali. That time actually writing, I was very expressing my painful experience. Maharaj speaking that you will have to do sampradayak seva. I am very happy to find that you have seva mood. You can do seva. You will have to do sampradayak seva. These, that, so many things giving instruction to me. But later on, I was very surprised to see how it is possible. I have nothing. I am now penniless. I am sitting here doing bhajan, begging chapati from Brahman house, you know. How I can do seva? But later on, I find all coming successful. By the mercy of Maharaj, it was possible for me to start publication seva. By the mercy of Guru Maharaj, Santu Goswami Maharaj, I was successful, somewhat, to publish so many books, this, that. By their mercy, it was possible. So, what he spoke long ago, it came true in my life, successful, this way. So when I was actually young age, that time usually when I am going to act as an editor, who is going to obey me? Because my age is not, I am not senior. In that case, who is going to obey me? So I was in fix, what to do? So everybody is sending, writing to me. I am checking up, going to computer job there, different language. So those who are senior devotees, they are giving instruction to, hey, don't change Samal Krishna, don't try to change any word, be careful. Say, okay, no problem, cannot change. Even if I find some Siddhanta Virod, still I am very fearful, they can beat me. What to do? In that case, I took decision to approach Srila Santo Goswami Maharaj. In that case, I took decision to go to Srila Santo Goswami Maharaj with their writing. Maharaj said, what for you are coming? Maharaj has some reason. I am going to read some Siddhanta in front of you. You will have to speak. Yes or not. Is good, then you can say yes. It's not, you can say no. Okay, you go on reading. What to do? Then I went on reading. They are writing. Hey, stop, stop, stop. It's wrong. Then I underline. Okay, it's wrong, Mara. Then what Siddhanta? If I write Siddhanta this way, yes, it's good. Then this way, I was bound to take advantage of Srila Santo Goswami Maharaj. Because Guru Maharaj was as a very aged, 90, 99, 100 years says that time, 100 complete, 101. So we cannot disturb. So this way, actually, I was bound to take the help of Srila Santo Goswami Maharaj, and I was successful. When the article, when all article I print and publish, they become very angry. Why you change this point? I say, I'm not changing. Then, actually, Srila Santo Goswami Maharaj, oh. If I say the name of Santo Goswami Maharaj, they stop speaking anything. Actually, I am not. I went to Santo Goswami Maharaj checking. Maharaj was the editor. I was the actual forso. I was. So they stop. They are not speaking anything against me. So this way, I was bound to take that, I mean, the help of Santo Goswami Maharaj. Many times, some senior foreign devotees, they used to take me. Hey, Samal Krishna, come with me. I was servant. Hey, come with me. Srila Rishikesh Maharaj. Rishikesh Maharaj, he was from America. Rishikesh Maharaj, he was from America. He opened one Malaysia, one mosque he opened. Now no more, actually 15 years ago. And now I get, already take information that Nishinga Maharaj also gone. Oh my God. He gone. Then Rishikesh Maharaj, senior devotees, I am servant. They say, hey, Samal Krishna, come with me. Where? You have to take me to Santo Goswami Maharaj because we like to discuss something. You will have to go with me. Then I go with them. Then I go and pay dandavat to Santo Goswami Maharaj. Why? What for you come? Some reason. The senior devotee coming to discuss with some point. Okay. They cannot. So this way, Srila Maharaj speaking always straightforward. Maharaj always speaking all about what Prabhupada told, Bhaktivinoda Thakur told. This way, all the time, massive preaching was done. Still today, if you go to any field in Midnapur belt, everywhere you can find the name of Srila Santo Goswami Maharaj. So powerful. Speaking Harikatha so nicely. He used to love us. Many times we have seen Maharaj, some devotee want to take undue advantage of Maharaj's love. From temple committee send me to invite Santo Goswami Maharaj, it's okay. After that, when from here my Guru Maharaj send me to with car to take Santo Goswami Maharaj and bring here in Mayapur. I went, Maharaj, you will have to go. Yes, I must go. My Shiksha Guru, Bhakti Bhumaturi Geshema, I will have to go. Then Maharaj, you can go, Maharaj, you see. There is small car. Ambassadors, there is no place. But Maharaj asking, you must go with me. You must go with me. Then after that, fine, Maharaj, no place for Maharaj to sit. But still Maharaj said, they must go. They must go. This way they are going with Maharaj. Maharaj has no place to sit properly. Still Maharaj, allow them to go. You must go with me. Last time when he came here, actually, Rudradip Mahat was destroyed 2-3 times by Ganga. Ganga, soil erosion. 2 times gone, that's third temple. When the temple, I mean second temple. That was the third, this is. That time Sri Santa Goswami Maharaj came with turban and everything and came, speaking Harikatha. That time old age, sitting, I have seen. I was, you know, playing handpan to them. All senior Vaishnava speak, sitting, and play, there is no fan, nothing. Playing handpan, they're speaking Harikatha, so heavy, you cannot hear. If I speak, you can go mad. Maharaj sometimes used to speak slag language, very heavily. Hey! You say, go! So heavy. So Maharaj was very strict actually. Now actually situation changing. And one special thing, Guru and Shishya, what kind of love can be there between Gurudev and Shishya that we feel in the life of Sri Santa Goswami Maharaj? One of his disciples, one. That is from Kharagpur, Sagar Maharaj. He was from Kharagpur, main mart there, Kharagpur from station. When Sagar Maharaj was very loyal, Sagar Maharaj was 100% inclined unto the lotus feet of Santa Goswami Maharaj. So loveful relation. That Santa Goswami Maharaj believed him 100%. One day, Srila Santa Goswami got one letter. Gurudev, my health is very bad. I am going to hospital for operation. I think I cannot come back. So I am going to speak you that this is the bank balance of, you know, a temple. This is the property I keep here. This is the ornament I keep here. This amount I keep with that man for temple seva. All, even not even one single paisa, Maharaj keeping for his own. When Santa Goswami reading this letter, that Gurudev, maybe I am not going to come back anymore, he started crying. Only after reading, when Maharaj Sagar Maharaj wrote, maybe I am not going to come back, so I speak you all account. There is the amount kept in bank, and this amount I keep there, and this ornament I keep there, all deity, everything. Maybe I cannot come back. My health is very bad. Then Srila Maharaj started crying like child. Then really so. After operation was done, the operation was not successful, and Maharaj leave body. When information came to Srila Maharaj, Bhakti Mahi Santa Goswami Maharaj, Maharaj cannot stand. Maharaj is just like child, crying and crying, like mad, and speaking heavily. Before going, already Maharaj told, I am not going to come back. Maharaj speaking, in my whole life, I get one nice disciple. One nice disciple. Not only that, up to last moment, many times used to go. When I go to Calcutta, sometime used to go there to take darshan of Srila Maharaj. But last time when he was manifesting Sikh Leela, that time on special occasion used to go. There actually, I saw when I go to pay Dandavat to Maharaj, I saw the picture of Sagar Maharaj. Suppose Maharaj is in bed, and here the picture of Radha Madan Mohan, and picture of Guru Varga, and picture of that disciple. Every morning time when Maharaj get up, watching that picture of disciple, you see. Now you see. Used to see. Up to last moment we have seen the picture of Sagar Maharaj was there. Maharaj used to watch. So what kind of love a Gurudev can have with a disciple? That is the document. That is the document. We should not take undue advantage of Gurudev's reputation, name, fame, and position. Most of us at present going to take advantage of Gurudev. My Gurudev is very famous. Bhakti Pumatpurishima. Everybody knowing his name. Who not? So I can take advantage. You see, I am the disciple of Bhakti Pumat. Oh, really? He can worship me, give pranami, pay respect to me. This is the situation at present. We can never become a neutral personality. You always have some party color. If that Maharaj is giving some facility, hey, that Maharaj is very, very nice. This is the situation. So, today I am going to pray. So many things I like to discuss, but time cannot permit. Today I am going to pray unto His lotus feet, so that He can bless me. I can go ahead in my Hari Bhajan properly. No duplicity can touch my heart. I can speak all about that absolute truth. Maharaj, Srila Santo Goswami Maharaj, Srila Sagar Maharaj, Sagar Maharaj, not this Sagar Maharaj, Prabhupad disciple, Sagar Maharaj, Bhakti Vardhan Sagar Maharaj, Bhakti Niray Giri Maharaj, Nayanananda Babaji Maharaj, Bhakti Vallabh Tirtha Goswami Maharaj, Achi Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Maharaj, Srila Santo Goswami Maharaj, Kanupriya Baba, who not? Bano Baba, follow. Guru Maharaj, all they give instruction to me to engage in Bani Seva, to speak Harikatha. So I never want to take undue advantage of my Harikatha because it is spoken by Guru Bharga. So I have nothing new. What they are speaking, what they are doing, I will have to speak this way. I am going to pray unto His lotus feet today. His disappearance day. Today, he wanted to cheat me because I was not favorable to serve Guru Vaishnava. So, seeing my negative mood, after watching my negative mood, they wanted to pass away me and go on to this eternal world. From there, they can bless me so that someday I can get quality. Vancha kalpataroshya ki pasindhi bhavaja patitanang bhavane bhavishna bhyonam. Bharati Maharaj used to speak very nicely. He was association directly, more than me. Bharati Maharaj used to stay with him long time. So any question if you have? No?
Right. Oh, huh. I have one question.
What question? Consciousness is there, but is covered up. Jivatma mean chit particle, na? Jivatma mean ki? Chit particle. Jivatma mean chit particle. Chit particle mean eternally existence. Chit particle mean there must be. It is quite natural, but it is covered up by Maya. I can discuss this point next day, maybe Pusha Abhishek on 10th. That day I can speak clearly. Shyam Jivatma coming from Sankarshan. I can discuss this point. Even there in Golok, even in Vaikuntha also. From Mul Sankarshan and from Mul Sankarshan, Baladevji Maharaj, Baladev, they are actually eternally always ready to serve Krishna. Nitya Mukta. And Another group, those who are in Vaikuntha Jagat, they are also coming from Sankarsan to render 10 types of different seva. Bhaktivinoda Thakur in Chaitanya Sikshamrita writing, they are always serving in different way. Follow what I say. One example I can give next day, you can understand. Where our digestive system is there inside. Our digestive system is there, no? Inside. So according to demand, secretion coming, you know, secretion, you know, different kind of secretion coming inside. Even when you are taking curd, sweet ball, chili, what you are taking? All different kind of enzyme, all different kind of enzyme and secretion going to help, going to help you to digest. Follow. One enzyme going to digest sweet portion. One enzyme going to digest chili, oil, ghee. What to speak more? This tongue is so, you will have to learn so many things from this tongue. You are foolish. Those who are paramahansa are always learning something from dog also. From dog, you have to learn something because dog is faithful. Dog is always satisfied with any amount of food. Today only getting one bread, one chapati, sleeping nicely. Follow. Are always ready to serve guru, serve master, faithfulness. So from dog I will have to learn something. He is sleeping very nicely, like Sadhu. Sleeping very nice. Some dog. We have to learn. When Guru Maharaj used to serve Guru Maharaj, that time I used to sleep like dog. When one shack, you know? Potato sack. Jute sack, you know? That time no plastic sack. As you see. Who is speaking? Sleeping this way? Yes, very nice. If I sleep nicely, I can sleep nicely. I cannot get the scope to serve you. This way, Srila Bhavan Goswami Maharaj broke his hand and rib. Mahasingh, Sevak sleeping, well, let him sleep. I should not disturb. He going himself, old age, and was catching. In bathroom, they were sleepy. Was fall down and break this rib. Follow, you see. So what I mean to say, next day I can give example, that one enzyme going to help you to digest sweet portion. One enzyme going to help you to digest wild portion. Even from tongue, you have to learn. If I touch, I am cooking now, na? If I touch wild, I have to wash with soap. But the tongue is so nice, if I take so many butter and oil, after some time you say there is no oil and butter, nothing there. So you have to learn something. You will have to learn something from your tongue. That tongue is there among all enemy. That your teeth, all enemy. All your teeth, na? All enemy. Any time, any mistake, then they can cut the tongue. If tongue going to make slight mistake, then teeth can cut and blood can come. But still, that tongue not going to complain. The why you cut me. At the same time, when you are feeling some teeth ache now, oh, I'm feeling teeth. So many pain in your teeth. Teeth ache. Headache, teeth ache. That time your tongue always going, touching this portion, which is dangerous, and saying, oh my brother, how you are? Your tongue speaking. If any danger is here, but tongue always going to take information, how you are now, how you feel. Follow, you have to learn. Tongue is very big sadhu. All our Guru Varga sadhu. So I can give example, bonded soul, what condition? Mukta Purusha, you can fight with me. Why Mukta Purusha there? Bhagavan is not impartial. Why not? Sankarsan from Balaram coming some group. They are also jiva. They are also nitya mukta, always serving, mood. And from, you know, from Mahavishnu, another, you know, jivatma coming, I mean, tatasya sakti, you know, jeep sakti. They are also, they can get free. When they are going to enjoy Sarup Shakti Kipa, when they are going to enjoy Sarup Shakti Kipa, they can also get free and engage in eternal seva. So Maya is so strong, I cannot speak in philosophy. You will have to be alert all the time. 24 hours, whole life, you will have to be very careful. You have to put question yourself, you have to, I am making any mistake? I am making any mistake? I am, all the time, be careful. And if you have the right scope to get the association of Srila Santa Goswami Maharaj, Bhakti Puma Puri Goswami Maharaj, Sadhu Sangha. Only and only will have to do Sadhu Sangha. Lack of Sadhu Sangha putting the whole world into the ocean of misery. Only one thing, I am in Vyasasana speaking. If at all, if you are going to take right association, I cannot forget. I can never forget in my whole life the association of Bhakti Bhuma Turi Goshima, the association of Santo Goshima. I can never forget until my last death. What kind of love I got from them, affection, I cannot forget. That is my treasure. Maybe you can find no bank amount there, but still, this is my treasure. Only. So always I like to guide myself. You can think there is no guidance in your life. Who told you? You stay with me and see, watch. If you are going to express some doubt, you can ask those who are staying with me. They can speak you what I am doing. Then you can watch as if Santo Goswami is putting one danda behind me. Hey! Always with one danda ready. So I am doing my bhajan this way. Don't think that Guru Varga is not there with me. I feel Guru Varga is always there with me. I feel all the time that Guru Varga is there with me. Yesterday some master from Canning, he is opening one special website, only Bengali. bhaktisiddhanta.org Bengali. All Bengali katha. He is speaking, we are watching here all the time in TV. We connect, okay. He is putting some question. Actually, I told him that I am not going to take help, undue help from anybody. If at all, sevak is not there, actually sevak is not there, I am sufficient to do. You can go mad. I am doing bhajan night time, okay. Now I am not going to express something. Technique. I put water in the oven, water boiling. Here I am doing bhajan, doing some path, everything. Then run, wash the rice and I mean chal and put in the water. Then again come. This way I have some technique. Follow. When doing seva, he want to help me. Maharaj, I can come. Oh, no, if you come, it is great headache for me. Yes, yes, I will have to guide them. I know everything. If Torun Krishna is not there, okay, no problem. If somebody want to do, I can help him go seva. No, I will have to do your seva. You cannot do go seva. What go seva you can do? I will have to help you. You don't know. You have no seva mood. So better I am alone. No problem. Brajavasi is there. One Brajavasi Brahman coming. He is very nice, love me very much. I say Brajavasi is in from Radharani, Rabel, birthplace. He is my heart. I love all Brajavasi. So for so long time I was in Braja. Never I develop any fighting in any Brajavasi. I told that Brajavasi, I am going to give heart to you. You like to take this Gosala? I take. You stay here. Maharaj, I can stay. He is staying, helping me. And I am cooking everything. Now I can run and start cooking. Within 1 hour I can finish everything. Follow. You have to do. Because if I am not going to help myself, how I can do bhajan? So Maya, not a big problem. Big problem is that you are concentrating on material things. Big problem. So Prabhupada told, material people can go on speaking about material thing, worldly thing. Prabhupada told, I can discuss next day. Prabhupada told, material people can go on speaking all about worldly things. You need not pay concentration, attention to their speech. But don't try to insult them, give them honor, but don't try to accept any siddhanta vichar from them. Don't try to accept any behavior from what was the advice of Prabhupada. Bhakti Siddhanta, sir. Prabhupada says, you can give honor to them. Don't insult them. But externally you can pay. Internally, I am going to pay dandavat to Santa Gosimara all the time. Externally, I will have to pay some respect to somebody, senior person. I cannot insult them. So Prabhupada speaking, you should not accept any behavior from them. Be careful. You will have to go to market. You will have to go here and there. Who can stop you going here and there? You will have to go. But you must be very careful all the time, mental. Mental association is topmost thing. Physical association you cannot get sometime. Because Santa Goswami Maharaj gone, Guru Maharaj gone. How I can get physical association? Physical association also important. Jiva Goswami was speaking, physical association also important. Bonded soul cannot mentally, how they can do? Mental association very important, but for common devotees, physical association very. But physical association, where from they get? They want to hear very sweet Harikatha. So sweet. Sweeter than honey, they can speak so nice way. They say, that's their popularity. Lakhs of people, subscriber. But if I request them to speak all about Prabhupada told, let me see how many subscribers they can enjoy. Viewers? Huh? There are mixed people in the world. Some want to make some advancement in spiritual life. Some want to take undue advantage of this, you know, situation in which they are put into. They are with Tilak Mala, they are busy to collect money. Simply. Balance. So many huge property these days. They are busy with this. Somebody in the form of sannyasi and brahmacharya is ready to get some association, no? Woman association. Very nice, we can enjoy. Enjoying mood. So long as enjoying mood is there in you. Not enjoying mood. What to speak about enjoying mood? Smell of enjoying mood. You cannot expect to start Hari Bhajan. Harirhi nirguno shakshat purusho prakate parehe is spoken by Shukdev Goswami to Parikshit Maharaj. Harirhi nirguno shakshat purusho prakate parehe is beyond this material conception. Prakate parehe is turiyo. Krishna chinmoy. Harirhi nirguno shakshat prakate parehe. You cannot. I can discuss another point. I can discuss that tatro bhagavata dharmano shikshet gurvatma dayvataha. This slok I can discuss next day. So vanchakalpaturus ki vasnaputrum. You can do bhajan. I can speak. If you are going to enjoy Sadguru kipa, first of all you will have to take shelter unto the lotus feet of Sadguru. If you are not going to enjoy the kippah of Sadguru, in next thousands of births you cannot expect to come out successful. Sadguru you will have to take shelter first. Even Madhyam Adhikari is there. Even Madhyam Adhikari, perfect Madhyam Adhikari, still okay. Don't try to leave Gurudev. But you will have to take help of one Siksha Guru. Follow. To make further advancement. Even Madhyam Adhikari, Guru, you cannot leave. By chance your luck was there. Follow what I say. So